Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullah. Assalamu alaykum.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. نحمده تعالى ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهدي الله فهو مهتد ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا واتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن الأصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة وأهلها في النار وعياذ بالله وإياكم من النار هبت في الله. I pray that this blessed month of Ramadan has began and you have begun in this month in a excellent state, because this is a ni'mah min ni'amillah. It's a great blessing from amongst the many blessings and reward of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's a time for us to come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's a time to seek forgiveness from Allah azza wa jal. It's a time to supplicate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for everything that you need and for the rectification of the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because many of us come from many different lands and we have fawda and chaos in our lands. And we need Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can rectify our situation and status. Ahabatifillah. So ask yourself, Ahabatifillah, what is the purpose of Ramadan? Or what should we be gaining from Ramadan? Qala subhanahu wa ta'ala fi kitabihi al-aziz. Kutiba alaykum as-siyam. Kama kutiba ala al-ladhina min qablikum. La'allakum tattaqun. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has legislated this beautiful month for us, as He legislated for the people before us, in order to gain taqwa, in order to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that means when you come to the masjid, that you fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you leave the masjid, you lower your gaze from the muharramat and the sayyat that we see on the streets. And that when you finish praying qiyam al-layl, that doesn't mean you rush to go to your films and rush to watch the new series, but rather fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and know that He sees you. Ahabatifillah, our Shaykh Abu Salah al-Afghani, hafidhullah ta'ala, he mentioned a great faida with regards to the concept of sawm versus siyam. A sawm, ahabatifillah, a sawm refers to fasting as we fast from fajr to maghrib, and we don't eat, we don't drink, and we don't have relations, akramakum Allah. But siyam, as is mentioned in so many nusus from the book of Allah and the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we see that siyam, that refers to those extra ibtiad an al-ma'asi, that you're staying away from the sin. Not just that you're thirsty and you're hungry, but rather you're lowering your gaze when you have the opportunity to look. That you're restraining your hand when you have the opportunity to touch. That you are not doing ghibah and namima, and you're not cursing people when they cut you off on the road or engaging in backbiting about this one or that one. That is siyam. So that is the amur al-batiniya command. So taqwa, habatifillah, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has legislated this month for us, taqwa, as the ulama mention, that it is adhering to the commandments of Allah and avoiding His prohibitions. And hadha yashmal iman kulli. That includes all of iman, really. That you are avoiding, you're doing the commandments of Allah and you're avoiding His prohibitions. All the muharramat, from the small to the large. So we need this reminder. We need to implement this in our lives. And think about the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when he talked about ihsan and the muhsineen. قال, when he was asked about ihsan, he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "And ta'budu Allah ka'annaka tara, fa in lam takun tarahu fa innahu yarak." It is to worship Allah as if you see him. And because you cannot see him, know that he sees you. If we carry that around with us, ahabati fillah, think how much sins we would avoid when we're alone, when we want to listen to those old tunes we used to love, when we want to look at this, when we want to look at that, when we're in the souk. If we know that Allah sees us and we worship him as though he sees us, it will prevent us from so much. Fasting, ahabati fillah, it heals the heart. And it cleans the spiritual ailments that we have, the sicknesses and the sins that we've collectively accumulated. And it expiates the sins. It's a kafara. An Abi Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qal, salawat al-khams wal jum'atu wal jum'ati wa ramadan wa ramadan mukaffirat ma baynahunna idha ijtanab al-kabair. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in a hadith in Sahih Muslim, he said that the five daily prayers and the Jumu'ah to the Jumu'ah and Ramadan to Ramadan is a forgiveness for everything that happens in between those times. That means every salat, when you make wudu, from Fajr to Dhuhr, the sins that you do are forgiven. And from Dhuhr to Asr, they're forgiven. And from Asr to Maghrib, they're forgiven. And from Jumu'ah to Jumu'ah, they're forgiven. But, walakin, the Prophet ﷺ said, إِذَا اجْتَنَبِ الْكَبَائِرِ. Meaning if you stay away from the major sins, if you do the major sins, the only way of forgiveness is making tawbah to Allah, repenting to Allah, making ikhlas lillah, and feeling sorrow in your heart, and cutting off the sin, removing yourself from those sins. Now that we began Ramadan, ahabatifillah, from the first day, the benefits and mercy have begun. And the gates of rahmah are open. Qala sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, إِذَا جَاءَ رَمَضَانَ فُتِحَتْ أَبْوَابَ الْجَنَّةِ وَغُلِقَتْ أَبْوَابَ النَّارِ وَصُفِدَتْ الشَّيَاطِينَ. Mutafakun alayhi. In this hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said that when Ramadan begins, that the gates of paradise are opened. So that means this is the time for mercy. It's the time every second. SubhanAllah, we just lost 10 seconds. We just lost a minute. We just lost how many days? We're in the third day, I believe. We're losing ground with Ramadan. So every minute counts. So he says that the abwab al-jannah are opened. And the doors of the hellfire are closed, and the shayateen are locked, they are chained. So this is a big fursa for us, that now we experience from the lesser shayateen from amongst mankind. We might find shayateen outside in the souk, you know, people who bother you, people who want you to break your fast, people who want to harm you. But the shayateen, the major shayateen, are locked. وقال صلى الله عليه وسلم إن لله تبارك وتعالى عتقاء في كل يوم وليلة. So the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام said that every day of Ramadan that Allah is freeing people from the hellfire. He's freeing us from the hellfire if we're doing the righteous deeds, if we're avoiding the sins. And we know what we need to look for, as far as what we should have our intention for. Of course, fasting, every day we need intention. But we need to also look forward to the end of Ramadan as well, in that we look for Laylatul Qadr, the night of power, the night when the Quran was revealed. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, في كتابه المبين, إِنَّا أَنزَلْنَهُ فِي لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ خَيْرٌ مِّنْ أَلْفِ شَهْرٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, verily, we have descended upon you a Laylatul Qadr, the night of power. And what will make you know what the night of power is? The night of power is a night which is better than 1,000 months. That means in barakah. That means in your getting your reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that means you have to ijtahid, that you have to work hard to do righteous deeds during that time. And in this regard, our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّ هَذَا الشَّهْرَ هَذَرَكُمْ وَفِيهِ لَيْلَةٌ خَيْرٌ مِّنْ أَلْفْ شَهْرٍ مَنْ حُرِمَهَا فَقَدْ حُرِمَ الْخَيْرُ كُلِّهِ وَلَا يُحْرَمُ خَيْرَهَا إِلَّا مَحْرُومٌ. And this is a hadith, Ruwahu ibn Majah. In this hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, verily in this month, or that this month is now present, and just like it is now. Now we're in Ramadan. And during it, there is a night which is better than 1,000 months. Whoever is prohibited from it, then they are prohibited from all good. And no one is prohibited from it except that they are mahroom. This is shadeed jiddan. This means that the one who doesn't make Laylatul Qadr, meaning intentionally that they're lazy, they're tired of fasting, they're tired of standing in Qiyam, and now they just want to watch movies or they want to go out, there's concerts coming, there's this coming, they want to do other activities. No, at that time, you need to strive even more to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and be strong as the Messenger, alayhi salatu wassalam, did in his sunnah. Ahabati fillah, there is no comparison to fasting, as we know. That fasting, the ajr of fasting, even one day, there is no reward like it. An Abi Umamata radiallahu ta'ala anhu, qultu ya Rasulullah, murni bi amal. فَقَالَ عَلَيْكَ بِصَوْمٍ فَإِنَّهُ لَا عَدْلُهُ قُلْتُ يَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ مُرْنِي بِعَمَلٍ قَالَ عَلَيْكَ بِصَوْمٍ فَإِنَّهُ لَا عَدْلُهُ رُوَاهُ النِّسَاءِ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, he was asked by Abu Umama radiallahu ta'ala, one of the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala majma'een. And the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'een were very vigilant in doing talab al-ilm. They wanted to know what was halal and what was haram. What would get them to paradise and what would take them to the fire. How to avoid the fire, how to get to Jannah. How to do good. They were always asking the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Abi Umama radiallahu ta'ala anhum, he asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he said, I said, Ya Rasulullah, murni. He said, O Messenger of Allah, tell me about a deed. And in the hadith, he said, Murni bi amal. He said, tell me about a deed. The Prophet ﷺ said, upon you is fasting, for verily there's nothing like it. Then he said, he wanted extra. He wanted to know, what else can he do? He said, Ya Rasulullah, Murni bi amal. The same question. And the Prophet ﷺ gave him the same answer, that it's fasting, because there is no reward like fasting. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله عز وجل. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. أما بعد هبت في الله. The Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام let us know that fasting also it takes you further from the hellfire. It is a way of putting a barrier. And as the Prophet ﷺ said in another hadith, he said, "Asum Junnah," that it's a shield to protect you from the nar. So the Prophet ﷺ said, "Ma min abdin yusum, ma min abdin yusum yomin fi sabilillahi ta'ala, illa ba'idallahu bidhalika al-yawm wajhuhu 'an an-nar 70 kharifa." The Prophet ﷺ said, he said, there isn't a servant that fasts even one day, fi sabilillah, except that Allah makes his face for that day further from the hellfire. 70 kharifa, and some of the scholars say that this means 70 years. So it shows us how important just the fasting that we take for granted. But if we fast and we're conscious, we know every minute we're getting reward. You're in the khutbah right now. You're getting reward for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You're tired. I know. You're tired of hearing me. I know. But fast and be patient and listen to the khutbah. Lillah Azza wa Jal. And the reward is immense. You will never even have an idea about the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Fasting, ahabatu fillah, it brings two forms of happiness. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam said, لِلْصَائِمِ فَرْحَتَانِ يَفْرَحُهُمَا إِذَا أَفْتَرَ فَرِحَ بِفِطْرِهِ وَإِذَا لَقِيَ رَبُّهُ فَرِحَ بِصَوْمِهِ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, for the person who fasts, there are two types of happiness, or two times of happiness. He says, they become happy when they break their fast. And they will also be happy when they meet their Lord for the reward of fasting. Ahabati fillah, the last point I want to mention here during the course of this khutbah is this happiness we want to share with all of our brothers. That this happiness all of us as people who fast will receive. But there's another type of joy that we need to consider. There is a group from amongst us, ahabati fillah, that they left their family. They left their community. They left their previous deen. They have been rejected similar to the Sahaba to Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'een. And those are our revert brothers and sisters. Ahabati fillah, when I look around the masjid here, I don't see one revert aside from myself. This shows that we are not doing the work that we need in da'wah Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Our community around the masjid would be better with us if we're doing da'wah Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and we're giving them the excellent adab of the Muslim. Ahabati fillah, we have a duty to our brothers and sisters. They left everything. Can you imagine being a sister, you embrace Islam and they take your hijab off. They threaten to kick you out of the house, or they kick you out of the house. Maybe you're homeless and you did that lillah subhanahu wa ta'ala because you were coming to the Islamic Brotherhood. And then the sisters didn't even really hardly give you salams. And the sisters never invited you for Eid. And the sisters never broke their fast with you. So it's so important. Sometimes we forget, because most of you were born Muslim. Walillahi alhamd. May Allah bless you and your families. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. But however, many of us, we don't have that. So sometimes we even become sad when we break our fast, because we go home alone. We become sad. Yom Eid, you're happy. But a lot of us are so sad. Some people cry because they're by themselves. No one invited them. No one said, Akhi so-and-so, Ukhti so-and-so, please come. Come with us. We're having a good time. I want to meet you to meet my family or something. So don't forget that, because you will receive ajr. And that is the Islamic Brotherhood. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, fi kitabi al-kareem, innama al-mu'minun ikhwa. And that's from Allah. That's not even because I want to be a certain culture or you want it. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. We're brothers by default. We're brothers by the kitab wa sunnah. That's it. There's no say after that. That's it. We're brothers. Subhanallah. Wa qala sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a Muslim akhul Muslim yashadduhu ba'dahu ba'dah. The Prophet ﷺ said the Muslim is the brother to the Muslim. They strengthen one another. So strengthen yourselves during this Ramadan and strengthen your brotherhood and do the best you can under the pandemic. But at least greet your brothers, check on your brothers, call them, check on your sisters for the sisters. You know, do those good deeds and don't take for granted even 1 minute of this Ramadan. One good deed. Maybe you don't have money to give to the masjid or to give to the poor, but you can smile. You can go outside and you can smile. Lillah! And you'll get reward. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty, to accept our good and forgive our evil. Asal Allah an yu'inana jami'an ala siyam wal qiyam wa an yataqabbal minna hadha shahr. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب. وأقيم الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله هيا للصلاة هيا للفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
So straighten your sajadas as best as you can, inshallah ta'ala. Obviously we have gaps. Allahu Akbar. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين فلا أقسم بمواقع النجوم وإن القسم لو تعلمون عظيم إنه القرآن كريم في كتاب مكنون لا يمسه إلا المطهرون تنزل من رب العالمين أفبهذا الحديث أنتم مدهنون وتجعلون رزقكم أنكم تكذبون فلولا إذا بلغت الحكم وأنتم هنا إذا تنظرون ونحن أقرب إليه منكم ولكن لا تبصرون فلولا إن كنتم غير مدينين ترجعونها إن كنتم صادقين فأما إن كان من المقربين فروح وريحان وجنة نعيم وأما إن كان من أصحاب اليمين فسلام لك من أصحاب اليمين وأما إن كان من المكذبين الضالين فنزل من حميم وتسلية جحيم إن هذا هو الحق اليقين فسبح باسم ربك العظيم الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين أرأيت الذي يكذب بالدين فذلك الذي يدع اليتيم ولا يحض ولا تعامي المسكين فويل للمصلين الذين هم عن صلاتهم ساهون الذين هم يراءون ويمنعون الماعون الله أكبر سمي الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر Allahu Akbar. Assalamu alaikum rahmatullah. Assalamu alaikum rahmatullah. Astaghfirullah. 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 Thank you, salam.